Well, Alfie Boe is definitely coming up in the next hour of the programme. There's no question about that. That's because I spoke to Alfie earlier on in the week. Alfie Boe coming up at around about 10 past 11, talking about his brand new album called Trust. Now, over the last few years, Alfie Boe has become a bit of a sensation. The English tenor, well known for his operatic performances in things like Les Mis, also in La Bohème, has been really on the crest of a wave of popularity in the UK. That wave is also growing in the United States, and he is back with a brand new album and a brand new tour. The tour is going to be next November. The new album is out now. It's the follow-up to the acclaimed 2012 album called Storyteller. This brand new album is called Trust. I am talking about Alfie Boe, and Alfie Boe will be here in just a few moments.
Though we jump through hoops and we dance on wires, walk on broken glass and play with fire. Though we're blindfolded when we turn on the light, I know that everything will be alright. If you trust in true love and trust in time, trust in forever, trust this heart of mine. We can lose ourselves just like lovers do. If you trust in me like I trust in you, trust in me like I trust in you. Too many people that have been let down by broken promises on broken ground. And there's cracks in the pavement, I don't wanna fall through. Hold on to me and I'll hold on to you. If you trust in true love and trust in time, trust in forever, trust this heart of mine. We can lose ourselves just like lovers do. With rusty knives, trying to cut away the good in our lives. But I don't care what they believe. With you, I have everything that I need. If you trust in true love and trust in time, trust in forever, trust this heart. Just like lovers do. If you trust in me like I trust in you, trust in me like I trust in you.
It's BBC Radio Devon with Richard Green. Now, this gentleman has been on BBC Radio Devon in the past, but he's got a brand new album out, and it's a little bit of a change of style for Alfie Boe. The album is called Trust. You heard Trust just there, and Alfie's with me now. Hello, Alfie.
How you doing?
I'm all right. I'm not too bad. Now, it would be fair, wouldn't it, to say that this is a bit of a change, well, perhaps not of style, but of direction, a little bit.
It is. I wanted to do a punk rock album, but they wouldn't let me.
Is that right?
Yeah,
I could see you doing some Sex Pistols numbers.
Exactly. When I had the outfit and everything.
So what sort of style is it? Bluesy? Country?
It's got a Memphis vibe, you know, Memphis blues with an element of country. And also there's gospel feel on a number of tracks as well, which is wonderful. I mean, it's an album that shows that there is no boundaries. There's no divisions. It's incorporating a lot of different styles of music on that sort of front, that sort of area. And it works. It works, man. I just sing it the same way as I always sing my classical stuff, and it just suits my voice. I enjoy it.
Well, now, you see, that's interesting, because I was wondering whether Larry Klein, the legendary producer who worked with you on this album, I wondered if he'd actually sort of, you know, given you a bit of guidance as to how to sing some of these songs, because when I looked down... And I thought, OK, you've got a Friends on there, for example. Yeah. And I thought that's, you know, James Taylor's voice, Carole King's written it, etc. Yeah. And sometimes you think, well, you know, how's Alfie's voice going to play that sort of soft number? And I wondered if he pointed you in a right direction.
No, I mean, Larry was great to work with. I mean, obviously, being a producer, he listened to my voice in maybe a way that other people haven't heard it, and he did suggest trying different things, trying different elements to my singing and to the sound that I could produce, and he really brought a lot out of me. Yeah, so in a way he did help me, but the fundamental side of singing, the technical side of it, is still the same approach that I've always sung. I don't change the way I sing for the style of music. I always breathe the same way, place the sound in the same direction, but control it as I would an opera song.
It works very well. How did you come to select the 12 songs that you've put on the album, Trust?
You know, that's quite a process. You know, you find songs that suit your voice. You find songs that you'd like to try and sing or like to try out and see if they work. Some don't, some do. Some make it the lists, and some others you put aside for another time. There's a couple of original songs on there as well that were written. So that's a good direction that I'm looking forward to heading more into, writing my own stuff and in this sort of style, though.
Because it's been interesting for people looking on the outside, and they think about your past two or three huge selling albums, mainly since the Les Mis 25th. Anniversary spectacular, of course. They sort of think, well, Alfie Boe's been a bit of almost an overnight success. But I know that you've paid your dues for many, many years, working your way up to this point in your life.
Yeah, I've been singing for 20 years now, and I've been in the industry for 20 years. So it's not just been an overnight thing for me. I worked worked in classical music in the opera world for 15 years, working around Europe and England and America doing operas. But I always had a love for different styles of music. I grew up listening to lots of different music. I didn't grow up listening to classical all the time at home. It wasn't what I would rush home and put on the record player. It was rushing home and putting on an Elvis song, an Elvis album or a rock album.
Mind you, you would have had to fight to get to the record player, being one of nine.
I know, I did, yeah, that's true. And you had to pick your moments. But being the smallest, I could get through the little gaps.
Oh, good.
All right, yeah. But that was really what I grew up listening to, mainly. It's just music to me is one big world, and it, there's no difference in it, really.
I would agree and say that in music there's no such thing as a boundary at all. It's just either great cracking music or it's not.
A classical aria, a classical song written by Verdi or Puccini, can stand side by side with a Rolling Stones song. It's the same old notes on the same lines, just put in a different order. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I feel that...
You sound like Eric Morecambe there.
Exactly.
I'm playing all the right notes, not necessarily in the right order. But I get what you mean. I mean, quality comes through, doesn't it?
It does. And I believe that these composers back in the day that wrote this fantastic music didn't write their operatic scores and their symphonies as gospel. These are the notes that you should be playing. These are the notes that I've written down. You have to play them like that. I don't think they thought like that. I believe that they wrote their scores down as a guideline, as sort of like for the artist, for somebody to come and interpret them their own way and add their own flavour, which is what you get with rock music and pop music. People do songs in many different ways and add their own style to it and their own flavour to it. And I think that's the way that you could work classical.
Well, tell me a little bit about Keep Me In Your Heart. We'll hear that one now.
Keep Me In Your Heart is a beautiful song by a wonderful singer-songwriter, Warren Zevon.
Werewolves of London.
Werewolves of London, yeah. Absolutely, yeah. And the sentiment behind the song is just heartbreaking, you know. It can mean something different to many different people, you know. So it's whatever it wants, whatever you want it to be for yourself, really.
Shadows are falling and I'm running out of breath. Keep leaving your heart for a while. If I leave you, it doesn't mean I love you any less. Keep me in your heart for a while. When you get up in the morning and you see that crazy sun, keep me in your heart for a while. There's a train leaving nightly call when all is said and done. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while. Simple things around the house, maybe you'll think of me and smile. You know I'm tied to you like the buttons on your blouse. Keep me in your heart for a while. Hold me in your thoughts, take me to your dreams. Touch me as I fall in the view. Comes, keep the fires lit, and I will be right next to you. Engine drivers headed north to Pleasant Street. Keep me in your heart for a while. These wheels keep turning, but they're running out of steam. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while. Keep me in your heart for a while.
Gorgeous song, isn't it? BBC Radio Devon, Keep Me in Your Heart. It's Alfie Boe from his current album, Trust. Now, of course, when you come out with an album, Alfie, you do lots of promotion, as you're doing right now, of course, and then normally just around the corner, there's a tour as well, and yeah, that's in your diary.
That's right. The tickets have gone on sale, so they're available now. Start touring next year with this album.
A long time away, though, a year from now.
It is a bit of a while, but we've got a lot going on prior to that. You know, we've got a US tour happening, and a number of different concerts and few other different projects happening as well. So it's the only time that we could really get a chance to get on the road and play this music off the album, really.
How does it fit into family life, though, having to tour America? And obviously you've got your eye on the American audience, which is growing week by week and month by month.
I'm very fortunate the American audience are sort of coming on board slowly. But I love America. It's really nice to work over there and play to the audience there. It's hard being away from family. Got to say, it's really difficult being away from my kids and my wife. I miss them dreadfully when I'm on the road. But you know, it's part of the job. You know, my wife comes out to see me occasionally, and eventually when the kids are at school, they can come and on the road with me as well. And they love that. My little girl loves hotel rooms and mini bars and things. For the chocolate, not the alcohol.
And probably loves it when you visit Florida or somewhere, places
exactly.
Like that. Yeah,
But playing America is wonderful, but being on the road over here is where it all started for me, you know, travelling this country and seeing my fans and singing to my home crowd is what it's all about. I love it here.
All right.
I love coming home.
Well, listen, whilst I've got you, I've got to ask you a quick question. If I was to do a thesis in media, I think the topic for my thesis would be Baz Luhrmann, a genius, question mark. You've worked with him, obviously, on Broadway. What do you reckon?
I totally agree. I really agree. He's a genius as far as the shows that he does and the movies that he does. His visual his vision for movies and spectacular is incredible. He is a great guy, a great friend, and a wonderful man to work for.
Do you sense that you might work with him again?
Do you know you
might be working with him
that's
again?
That's why I speak so highly of him, just in case he's listening.
Well, I don't know whether he's got a pad in Devon, but you never know.
You never know. He's got a lot of people listening on the ground, ears on the ground, you know.
And what about Mr. Selfridge?
Yeah, that was a great thing for me. I loved doing that. I loved playing a different character on screen, something I've not really done much of before. So it was a new venture. For me, I was a little nervous going in the first day to do my scenes, but the director, Lawrence, was an incredible director, really helped me and really encouraged me. The cast encouraged me, the cast brought me on board and made me part of the family. Like I was an old member, really. It was lovely, really nice.
You see, it's interesting because you would think, looking from afar, that they'd say, OK, well, Alfie Boe, you know, he's been on stage in front of, you know, X amount of thousands of people, walking onto a sound set to do a bit of Mr. Selfridge or whatever, should be a doddle. Why would Alfie Boe get nervous about that? He's been in front of thousands.
Yeah, well, it's a different world, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, and it's different people. I'd not worked with them before, and I didn't really know any of them, and they didn't know me. So going on and doing the scenes where I had to sing was fine. I could do that, and do that over and over again. But the dialogue scenes that I had to do were a little... I was nervous about that, but I didn't want to mess up. I didn't want to spoil it for anyone or slow the process down. I wanted to do it to the best of my ability and fit in, you know, make it look like I'm an actor in this show and not a guest artist who's just come along and, like, status quo in Coronation Street, you know?
Yeah. Do you remember? I know what you mean.
You know, that was it, really.
Now, I've got to ask you, because I think you're doing a performance on Strictly Come Dancing on the 30th of November.
I'm not dancing.
No, but I've got to ask you to be honest. Yeah. Now, when you're there in that studio, and I've been to the Strictly stage and the programme, and you're there singing away, and then you've got some gorgeous young lady and a fabulous bloke dancing away and doing all their pirouettes and all that whilst you're trying to concentrate on singing.
Yeah.
Is it a bit distracting or what?
Well, I wasn't looking at the bloke at the time.
Well, OK, I can understand that.
It can be, but I think you just have to focus and sing the song as best you can. You've got that one moment to do it, so you've got to do it well, really.
Okay.
But I mean, those dancers are incredible. You know, the ladies are stunning to look at and amazing dancers, and the guys are really ugly. It's great. It's a wonderful show to be involved in. I've done it a couple of times now previously, and I love it. I really do love it. It's great.
Yeah, good fun. Well, listen, we're going to play you out perhaps with one of those that you said you've had a hand in from the album Trust. What would you like us to play out with?
Oh, my word. If you can, it'd be great to play out with Glory, Glory.
Glory, Glory, Hallelujah.
Yeah.
OK, that's what we'll do. Alfie, it's been a pleasure speaking to you.
Nice.
Alfie's album Trust is out now and the tour is happening next November, November 2014. Lovely to speak with you, Alfie. Thank you so much.
Nice to talk to you too. Take care.
Oh, glory, glory.
Glory, glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Since I laid my burden down.
Oh, glory, glory.
Glory,
glory.
Hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down. I'm going home to be with Jesus. Since I laid my burden down. I'm going home to be with Jesus. Since I laid my
I laid
my burden down.
BBC Radio Devon with Pastor Alfie Boe. Glory, glory, hallelujah, from his brand new album called Trust. We'll be having a bit of a rival to Alfie Boe on the programme tomorrow. The English tenor Russell Watson will be chatting with Judy all about his brand new album called Only One Man.